the last video, we talked about integrating functions, and we saw that integrating functions with respect to abstract measures was in general very difficult. We had to approximate our function with simple functions, then integrate all those infinite simple functions and calculate the supremum over all the integrals. It was definitely very difficult. Well, now we're going to see one of the many tools that we have to make these calculations a bit simpler, although we will usually use them just to prove whether an integral of a function is finite or infinite. But it's still a very handy tool to have, and it's extremely useful. And this is the Monotone Convergence Theorem. Now, before we start, let me remind you that if these videos are helpful, you can support the channel by donating a coffee with the link in the description of the video. Well, let's start with a theorem. In the Monotone Convergence Theorem, we have a sequence of functions in L+. And here remember that L+ was the family of functions that were from our space to 0, infinity, so non-negative functions that were measurable. We have a sequence then of non-negative measurable functions that are also increasing and for which the limit is some function f. So we're obviously trying to calculate the integral of some function f, and we were able to approximate this function with an increasing sequence of other functions. Well, the Monotone Convergence Theorem tells us that if this sequence is increasing and all these functions are measurable, then we can just calculate the limit of these integrals, and that will give us the integral of f. So we can actually rewrite this saying, well, f is the limit of these functions, so this is just the integral of the limit of these functions fn. So Monotone Convergence Theorem gives us the conditions under which we can pull the limit out of the integral. This is integrating with respect to some measure mu. Here I didn't write it, but we're assuming that we're working on some measure space x with a sigma algebra m and a measure mu, just any abstract measure space. And now this theorem is helpful because with the usual definition of the integral of a function, we had to calculate the supremum over all the integrals of simple functions that were smaller than f. Well, now we're just going to take a countable family because we're taking a sequence of measurable functions that increase to f. Before, the simple functions, although they were actually very simple, it was an uncountable family because it was over each and every one of the simple functions that were smaller than f. So you can see how this theorem is very, very important. Now the rest of the video is going to be the proof, so if you're not interested in watching it, just skip to the next one. The proof is not extremely complicated, but it is a bit technical. And the idea will be to prove this equality by proving less than or equal to and greater than or equal to. So let's first do this one. Let's first prove that the integral of f is less than or equal to the limit of the integrals. For that, what we first have to say is, well, if this limit exists. Now, because all of these functions are increasing, like that the sequence is increasing, and then we have that these integrals, I might skip that d mu, but I'm always integrating with respect to the measure mu. These integrals also satisfy this. And so we have that this is just an increase in sequence of numbers. So we can say that this limit exists. And when I say that it exists, I'm saying that it could be infinite. So all these functions are increasing and are increasing to f, so fn is also less than or equal to f, and this means that the integral is also less than or equal to. So because this happens for every n, then we can say that also the limit, because now this limit exists, will be less than or equal to just the integral of f. And now I'm already not writing all the t mu's, but that is redundant because we only have one measure to integrate with respect to. Okay, so we did the first part, and now we want to prove that the integral of f is actually less than or equal to the limit of all these other integrals. So now we're going to prove in this inequality. For this, we have to remember the definition of the integral of f. It was the supremum of all the integrals of all the simple functions that were below f. So if we take a simple function phi, that's below f, so phi simple, and we can multiply phi by some alpha so that this happens. So here what we have to do is take alpha in 0, 1. We take an alpha fixed and we have this. But now we want to involve these functions fn that increase to f. And so what we will do is define a family of sets that are going to be all the elements in the space, all the x, such that fn, so the index here is the same as the set evaluated in x, is greater than or equal to alpha phi of x. So we are essentially saying, well, when is fn between these two functions here? For which x is this thing moving? And now since fn is also smaller than or equal to fn plus 1, then we simply have that en is a subset of en plus 1. And also, trivially, we have that the union over all the possible ends of these sets en is going to be the entire space. Okay, so we have some property of these sets. It's an increasing sequence and they form the entire space. And now there is one particular thing that's very important here. What happens with this limit when n tends to infinity of the integral of phi, but only integrating over en with respect to mu? Well, this integral is actually equal to the integral over the entire space of phi with respect to mu. And this is just the notation that we use to say this. Now, the reason why this is true is because we can think of this integral over a particular set as a measure. And now, because we have these two things, using the properties of measures, we get this equality here. It's very simple to see, so I'm just not going to spend time with this. So we have that the limit of integrating in this set en phi is actually like integrating phi. This is an equal. And also, alpha times this integral of phi, we know that because alpha is a constant, we can just put it inside the integral. And now alpha phi, remember, when we are in en, so in this set, fn is greater than alpha phi. So as long as we're integrating on this set, this is less than or equal to, in this set, fn. So now we can just take limit and we obtain here alpha times the integral of phi over the entire space less than or equal to the integral of fn. So we can just say, well, this is going to be valid for every alpha, and remember alpha was between 0 and 1, so we can say in particular it's going to be valid for alpha equals 1, right? And so what we have here is that the integral of phi is less than or equal to the integral of f. And finally, taking supremum over all the simple functions phi that are smaller than or equal to f, here is fn, sorry, we have finally the inequality that we wanted. The integral over f here is less than or equal to the integral of fn, and that proves the monotone convergence theorem.